Hello people, welcome here. We will see in this video how to make motion with Adobe Flash Professional CC. This is important to make a more complex animation in the future. Leave comments to solve mistakes in pronunciation. For animation, it is commonly used a project based on ActionScript 3.0. So mind to choose it in the welcome page or in the new document window. Let's pick a random image. To add one, simply drag it onto your project. It will belong to the only frame existing at first. Our goal is to make this move, but leaving the image as it is, so without changing its basic graphical aspect. In Flash, this is called motion tween animation, that sets animation without changing the original design of the object. At first, in the layer that contains the object, you will see a single frame in your timeline and a white page as an icon on the left. This means that all objects inside such layer are static. Any object inside can have animation. Simply choose one and right-click on it. Then go to Create Motion Tween. In case the object is not a symbol or some text, Flash will ask you to convert it into a symbol first. When you create the motion, the track that contains the tween object will turn in blue, indicating that it is not static. You can enable or remove the tween in right-clicking on such track. You will see that the track is enlarged with as many frames as it is the current value of the frames per second below, which means being enlarged for one full second. Plus, the new icon next to the layer's name indicates that there is at least one object that has motion. How to set motion? Motion is decided through the keyframes, the small and the black dots you find inside the blue track. Each keyframe sets, for that instant of time, the motion properties of the object, such as position, angle of rotation, sides, skew, and so on. Any option that you can find in the transform window, used for the static objects as well. At each keyframe, these properties are fixed, but can be different for different keyframes, so that when passing from a keyframe to the next one, Flash goes from the first set of fixed properties to the next ones. Remember that you can change some of the properties of the object. Just select it and open the properties window. The speed depends on how many frames are between the two keyframes. The more they are, the more time you have to wait for the change. The stage gives you further information as well. The path shows the motion throughout the whole track. Its color is the color of the layer that contains the object. Each rhombus is a single frame of your project. A video is composed by frames, so assure to have rhombuses close at each other, or motion won't come up good. You can edit the speed, stretching or shortening the track, dragging with the Ctrl key down, or add or remove selected frames, right-clicking on them. More keyframes set a more complex motion, always decided by the couples of keyframes, one following the other. You can create a new one, pointing at a frame and transforming your object from the stage in any way. In the Motion Presets window, you can apply ready presets to apply to your objects, without setting all manually. You can modify your motion anytime. Simply select the frame that contains the single keyframe and right-click to manage or delete it. You can reverse the motion path set, right-clicking on the track, going to Motion Path and then to Reverse Path. You can edit the path very fast from the stage. enable the selection tool, click on the path and drag it to move it. You can edit first the position of the object at the keyframes, enabling the sub-selection tool and dragging the bigger points of the path. You can further edit selecting the path and holding Ctrl down to move sides, rotate and move fast. Delete selecting the path and using Ctrl and X. You can make curved paths as well. Simply activate the selection tool and approach the path on the stage when the path is not selected. When an half square appears, you will edit the object's position of a related anchor. If there is a curved line below your pointer, you will transform the straight segment into a curve. Mind that you are editing the curve without adding new keyframes. Keyframes must be added if you need to use the transform window for the object, and not when you simply edit the motion path. We talked about anchors and not keyframes. Keyframes are instances of time where position and some properties of the object do change. Anchors are just the fixed points of the motion path, the set where the object must go, but never touches any other property. The anchors can be seen if you activate the sub-selection tool and click on the stage. They are represented through squares and never rhombuses. This tool is used to work with these. Drag the anchors to move them. You can move the side handles to adjust any curve set. Hold Alt down to set just one handle per time. You can convert to curves straight lines, always holding Alt down. You can draw the motion path directly. Aside in a new layer, create a new line using the pen tool. If you have problems using the pen tool, watch the related video in our channel. Once done, simply copy the line. You can come back to your motion path and paste the line on it. Mind that you will lose any few of your previous path, anchors included. Much harder is to set a nonlinear speed throughout the motion path, for example when you want to set an acceleration to the object interested. The easiest way to do this is to start from the motion presets window. Go to default presets and search for the fly in and fly out presets. The first ones decelerate, the second ones accelerate. So for each part of the path that won't have a constant speed, simply apply a fly in or a fly out motion. Adjust the transparency using the properties window at the keyframes instance. Then you can adjust the path using the sub-selection tool. Make sure to overlap the object position between two different frame tracks. Then you just need to export your animation. Go to File, Export, and then to Export Video. The output video is .mov. So you may need Adobe Media Encoder to get different video formats. This is all. Check the next video to know how to make a shape tween animation to change the shape of your object moving. Thanks for watching.